Social.
Thank you.
Okay, kids, this is it. This is the moment we've all been waiting for. I've asked a great deal of you these past few weeks, hard work, sacrifice, and yes, even a certain amount of maturity. And you've pulled through for me. Well, except for Moana, who's been nothing short of a royal pain in the gazebo.
Don't mention it.
And now, the audience is seated, filled with friends, family, and even perfect strangers. Are you ready, kids?
No!
Get out there and break a leg.
What she say?
I think she said play an egg.
Stop the chicken noises. Lights. Music.
Person here.
That was the wrong music.
I know, I lost the other tape.
I want to see you after the show.
That figures.
How could you compare me to this, a boy child, heir to the throne?
Estonia is an unhappy place now.
Sad but true. The SERB places an unfair burden on his people and brutalizes them into compliance. And every time I confront him, he brushes me aside as if I'm some bothersome insect.
But you are the queen. Surely he must listen.
Alas, I am a powerless queen. This room rules until the day your father returns.
May it be soon.
I wouldn't count on it. You know how picky your father is when it comes to porcelain.
May it please the queen.
May what please the queen?
Prince Viscero wishes an audience, Your Majesty.
That does not please the queen.
Don't let him in, Mother.
Tell Prince Viscero I'm otherwise engaged.
He says it's urgent.
Tell him I'm feeling under the weather. Tell him I have the plague.
I told him that last time, Your Majesty.
Very well. Tell him I'm dead.
At once, Your Majesty.
What do you mean, delay?
The queen is dead.
Dead, you say?
Dead.
She will be missed.
Barely.
How dare you enter my chambers without my permission?
A miracle! She lives! I shall declare a day of celebration!
I told my attendant to tell you I was dead tired. She simply misunderstood.
Leave us, knave. I wish to speak to the queen in private. And how is Ivanhoe, heir apparent to the throne, doing this fine morning?
He's sleeping, and I don't wish him disturbed. State your business, Viscera.
So be it. Were that ever good news, I bring you. Were that ever glad tidings.
Your voice reeks of dark portent.
Afraid so. Word reached me not an hour ago that our great and supine ruler, your husband, your father, have fallen upon hard times. Very hard times. Oh, ye gods, take my heart, my soul, my bronze bongos even, but don't take my king.
What are you saying, Lucas? Are you saying?
Yep.
Dead? The king is dead?
Good Asta. He's been captured by the infidels.
Captured?
But in a porcelain shop.
He's doomed.
He understood the cheats.
Quiet, child. He is alive, and where there is life, there is hope.
That's a good one.
They're no doubt holding him for ransom.
True. The filthy slimes say they're releasing for 10,000 gold ponders, 11 milk cows, and 1,000 feet of beachfront property, undeveloped.
And I assume you've already gone about collecting it.
Would that I could.
What's that supposed to mean?
How can I go about collecting ransom when it defies the very wish of the king? How many times have I heard him say, not a penny for ransoms?
Not a penny for ransoms? Transoms! Not a penny for transoms! You know how much he hated those transoms. They reminded him of gallows.
Transoms, ransoms. What's the difference? There's a principle at stake here. If we give in to the infidels this time, there'll be no end to it!
You would let him die, then?
You can't put a price tag on honor. Believe me. What I do... strictly not. What I do is for the good of everything.
Yeah, well, where you're concerned, Viscera, ulterior and motives are synonyms. You want to be king.
I want to be king. Honest. If I wanted to be king, may lightning bolt strike me where I stand. Anyways, what would I want to be king? I mean, what would I want with him? Wealth, power, prestige, beautiful handmaidens, and the best seats at jousts. Anyways, I couldn't be possibly be king. I have an idea who's next in line for the throne. I couldn't be king unless something were to happen to the little man. Something horrible. Accident. Yes. Accident. God forbid.
I'll take my case to the Council of Lords.
I disbanded the council.
Then I shall appeal to the Order of Knights.
They're all on the Crusades.
Then I shall appeal to the Archbishop.
He's on administrative leave.
Then I shall take my case to the people.
They're all in prison.
Prison? All of them? Charged with what?
Littering. I'm determined to put a stop to it.
Treachery has a face.
Everybody has a face.
Uncle Busy, for once in your self-serving, smarmy life, do something good. Save my father. Please.
I'll think about it.
Thank you.
I thought about it. No deal.
Treason has a face.
Everybody has a face. Look, you're a little upset. That's understandable. Let me send him to a lady. He can fix you up a sedative, read your tea leaves or something.
Keep that evil sorcerer out of here.
Sorcerer?
He's a devil.
Well, if you don't want Medulla, let me send over the court jester. You guys could use a good laugh or two. Let me send Shecky over.
Keep the disgusting vermin out of my chambers.
Well, I really must be going now. They're opening a new vocational center for executions, and they've asked me to cut the ribbon. With an axe, no less. There's no humors like gallows humor.
Remember this, Visram. He who sows the seeds of discontent reaps a vengeful harvest, or something like that.
No, I'll keep that in mind. Don't play in the streets, kid. Ah! You bit me!
Oh dear, now I'll have to wash his mouth out.
Lucky for little Ivan, I'm not the kind of guy who holds a grudge. Well, I really must be going. If you have need of anything, don't hesitate to submit a request in writing. Goodbye!
Viper!
I'm afraid, Mother.
As you should be.
You don't think he'd do anything to Ivanhoe, do you?
This I do know. When Visser was a baby, they hung a sign on his grave. And this sign said, Cave Cato, beware of dog. The dog has grown into a wolf. See what I mean?
And the wolf has teeth.
Come, child. We must make preparations. The life of the future king is at stake.
And what if they were to make preparations? Professor, in his heart of hearts, was planning to ensure that he would be king. Any questions?
When do we reach the romantic part?
That comes later.
Why do we lose the power?
As long as you have inquisitive minds, there is cause for you.
Why did they lose power?
Beats me.
Is it right to request for power be directly proportional to one's inordinate sense of self-esteem? Is power the means or the end? If one man has power, but what's wrong with that if they choose to be good?
Well, there's nothing wrong with that. But, you see, power tends to corrupt. You've heard of
it. I was hoping for a simple answer.
Very well then. Man has some power because he ate the apple. Simple enough.
If Adam had eaten an apple, would women be less in power?
I thought you wanted to hear a story.
I do.
Well, I can't tell you the story if you insist on digressing.
I'm sorry.
Now, where was I?
Visera is plotting to be king.
Yes. Now, Visera had in his employ an evil magician named Medulla. Medulla started out to become an alchemist, but flunked out of alchemy school when he turned gold into lead. Visser met him at a used horse shelter and took an instant liking to him. He always admired him after a lot of straight face. And so, Visser made Medulla the court magician, a position of great importance. And, in return, Medulla was only too happy to do Visser's dirty work for him.
Well, it's not like we need another gesture on the circuit.
Every two-bit peasant with a mother-in-law joke thinks he's a jester.
Perhaps, but there's only one jester playing with Alice.
You're looking at him.
How is it you'll have the biggest gig of them all?
Good news and bad news, baby. When you're good, you're good. But when you're bad, you're really dead. I mean, you're playing the Yorkshire Cricket Circuit, and they don't like your jokes. They just stone you. Here, I'm talking drawing a quarter. I'm talking no return engagement.
Lucky for you, Viscera has an infantile sense of humor.
Bingo, and I got two jokes coming out my ears. You got anything for biliousness? Every time I talk about death, it rivals my Bible.
This should fix you right up.
Me, what do you call it?
Ploppeth, ploppeth, visit, visit.
I haven't seen that many bubbles in one place since champagne was invented.
Over the lip, through the gummit.
Watch out, stomach, here it coming. Not bad, what do you got in here?
A wonder drug. I call it arsenic.
Are you trying to kill me?
How many dead men have you ever heard die from an upset stomach? It works every time. Don't you want to finish it?
No, thanks. I'm trying to cut back on arsenic. The doctor says it gives me rigor mortis. Is that a yuck or is that a yuck? But seriously, folks, have you come up with any scheme to get rid of that pain in Viscera's neck?
You mean Ivan, huh?
You catch on kicking the leech out of me, Chudula.
I've got a few things up my sleeve. The prince will be here soon, as a matter of fact. The time has come for us to act. I assume you've heard about King Isidore?
Yes, a pity Viscera won't be able to raise the ransom.
I can see you're all choked up about it.
It shows, doesn't it?
If things work out, Shecky, within 24 little hours, you and I will be privy to the court of the king. How does that grab ya?
Long-term contract with all the girls? How do you think you grab me?
Got a minute, boss?
What is it, Astrid?
You have a customer. Says she wants a magic potion.
I'm expecting the prince. There's no way I can see her now.
But she says it's important.
Didn't I make myself clear, Astrid?
Perfectly.
No customers. Tell her to get lost.
Okay, Jeep. I'll tell her to take her money back stuffed with gold. Someplace else.
Whoa. On second thought, perhaps I can squeeze her in.
I figured as much. I caught your show last night.
Yeah? What'd you think? Everybody's a critic.
You better wait outside, Chucky. This won't take a minute.
I wait robbery never does.
That was so funny.
Yeah? How funny was it?
Right this way, lady. I told Miss Moneybags. I think it's overboard, but you would see to your knees even a man that turns himself had to wait.
What is it the Romans used to say?
In the arena, blind me.
First come, first served.
That too. How can I ever repay your kindness?
Oh, I'm sure we can work something out. That'll be all, Astrid. Now, what can I do for you?
I'm in need of a potion.
You've come to the right place. I'm hearing a special on potions this week. What kind of potion would you like?
What kind of potions you got?
You name it, I got it. Lotion potion, motion potion, devotion potion. I even got promotion potion if you're looking for a little upper mobility. I've got oceans of potions.
I'm in need of a potion. Protect a child from all cases of treachery and insurrection.
Got just what you need. Commotion potion. 3 tablespoons before bedtime and your kid will have a care in the world. It will protect you from all manner of treachery.
And how much is it costing?
How much you got?
1,000 gold fonders.
Well, you're in luck. In addition, I'm giving you this pamphlet from the Saxonian Lung Association. It lists 25 reasons why you shouldn't smoke oysters. For one, they're incredibly hard to light.
I don't smoke.
Good for you. There's nothing more disgusting than seeing a person with a smoldering oyster in his mouth.
And how much is, or how long is this potion lasting?
It varies from case to case. I say it'll be effective for 24 hours tops. Don't get any requests for promotion potions. You expecting a little turmoil at your place?
Any minute now. I must be going.
You look vaguely familiar to me. Have we met before?
No, I don't believe so. It was nice to meet you.
The pleasure is all mine.
Eyes, eyes, eyes. I'll have Prince Viscera of Saxonia, Duke of the Court of Worcestershire, Commander of the Royal Guard, and other big stuff.
I'm telling you, it looks stupid.
No one does it. It gives your character an added dimension. I said, Commander of the Royal Guard, and other
finger.
No apologies to Nessa, Your Highness. Get the shovel, Astrid.
Get it yourself. I'm going to lunch.
Would you mind tying your grub outside?
Not at all.
So, have you come to plan to get rid of Ivanhoe yet?
We have company, Your Majesty.
So I see.
Don't mind me. I'm just looking at your eyes and newts.
They're on sale. Buy three, get one free.
Well, have you?
Your Majesty, I've got a plan that's foolproof. Within 24 little hours, you'll be King of Saxonia.
Yummy. Let me hear it.
Buzz, 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 buzz.
Buzz, buzz, buzz.
Buzz, buzz, buzz.
Buzz.
So, you wouldn't, you couldn't.
Couldn't what?
$3.50 for a wing of bat?
That's not just any bat, lady. That's a designer bat.
Must be considered. Bend the twig, throw it back, Mary.
I have a theory of my own. The baby is born feet first, it will be evil.
Can nothing alter its course?
Only if the baby is dipped in lard at the age of two will it no longer be evil.
It will be sticky. Now, where were we?
Queen Nia was preparing for Viscera and his henchmen. She didn't know when they were coming, be coming, or how they were coming, but she knew they were coming.
How did she know that?
They announced themselves.
May it please the queen. May what please the queen? Great heavens, good to see you, Your Majesty.
Get the potion ready.
How could she be sure it would work?
She wouldn't, but it was her only hope.
Show the henchmen in.
At once, Your Majesty.
This is really exciting!
You're telling me.
Then what happened?
Viscera and his henchmen came onto it. They're wearing disguises, but that's before for a single minute.
Good morrow to you, Queen Nina.
And to you, good sirs.
Sorry to interrupt what must surely have been a pastoral moment. But we couldn't help passing through all of Saxonia without offering you the best deal on insurance today.
So you're insurance salesman?
However, did you guess? Our disguises have fooled her completely. She's at our mercy. I am Sir Vince. This is Sir Harvey and Sir Floyd. We represent
King Rigor
of our kingdom. Or something like that. We can offer you the best deal on life, health, horse, and wagon for a price you won't believe.
And what is the price?
$22.50 a month.
And a firstborn son.
No deal.
That sounds like a pretty good deal, Mom.
I know the price seems high.
There's no way I can do $22.50 a month.
I think she's wise. Let's just get this kid split.
You know what? I think you're right. No more kid gloves. This is a stick up. Hand over the kid.
Thank you.
You got your sound person here.
That's supposed to be dogs barking.
I lost the dog tape. Cats? Dogs? What's the difference?
I want to see you after the show.
That figures.
Well, I went down.
fairies, Aunt.
I told you to never go there.
Yeah, well, that's beside the point. Anyways, I was getting a drink from the water, and I saw my reflection. Boy, was I shocked. Mom, I don't look anything like you. I'm ugly. Too ugly, got no fur to speak, and these big feet, and this nose, you could plant a nest in this sucker. Mama, why am I so different?
Grandma!
What?
It's time to have a little talk with Junior.
Can't wait, I've got nuts to store.
No, you can't, it's time you learn the truth.
The truth?
Your grandmother will explain.
What is it, Sonny, having a little girl trouble?
Now, I will. Goodbye, Trudy. Look out, world! Here I come!
My son, you are tired. You have a long way to go. more.
Yeah.
mastered reading, writing, and philosophy. Everyone else in the Abbey feels known simply as Billy a fire's apprentice. Well, one thing, though, disguises his features, but another thing is disguised in a nominal spirit.
Tell me about it.
Well, for example,
come from?
Watermelon seed. Any more questions?
What's up, woman?
I was wondering if you'd get around that. What is a woman?
I asked you first.
What is a woman? A woman is fire and fancy, frolicking legs, contradiction of beauty, splendor of petty, as any creature could be. That is a woman.
Well, could you be a little more, I don't know, specific?
I've taken vows.
Will I know it when I see one?
Oh, indeed. But you cannot mistake a woman from a man.
How so?
They have little feet.
Little feet? That's it?
Seems disappointing.
Well, I was hoping for, I don't know, more.
Shame on you, that's called luck. Why don't you get your hands and knees and concentrate on wholesome things?
Can't help who I feel. Get to that age, you know.
Not a number of words. Get on your hands and knees. I will leave you now. And remember, this is hurting me more than it's hurting you.
Yeah, I doubt that. Wow. Yikes!
Well?
Hubba hubba.
What do you think?
If I told you, I'd be on my hands and knees for at least a month. I expected something different. But this... this? Zowie!
I must say, I'm a little surprised to hear a friar talking like this.
Oh, I'm not a friar. I'm simply attending the academy. I'm a senior this year.
Such fair a face. Such fine features. Be still, my heart. A senior, you say? What is your major?
Pre-monarchy, with a minor in phys ed.
You know, you bear a striking resemblance to our late Isidore. What is your name?
Why, it's Ivanhoe.
But Ivanhoe's dead.
Oh, right. I meant to say, Ivanhoe's my middle name. My friends call me... Billy Bob. Billy Bob Cartwright.
And where do you come from?
Just out, Dark Forest Way, third tree past the Gnarled Oak. And you? What is your name?
Lenore, of the House of Usher.
Long name.
I know, but my friends just call me House of Usher.
Do you want to play doctor?
You have much to learn about women.
Well, that's why I want to play doctor.
Do you find them attractive?
I haven't had as much fun looking at anything since I found those Da Vinci prints in Fred's closet.
Normally, I would find such comments like this offensive, repugnant even. But, coming from you, I find it hard to take offense. There's a childlike curiosity in those eyes, a mirthful innocence. And yet, behind it all, I sense a power and a majesty. Yes, Bob, all right. There is more to you than meets the eye. I think you are manifest to me.
Well, how long will you be staying in the act?
We leave at sunrise. We go to the joust at Hermiston's.
Well, you don't sound very excited about it.
If gloom costs a penny a pound, I could sell a load on my heart for a fortune. My father is sending me away as an offering to the king. Viscera wants me as his bride.
Viscera, tyranny has a face.
Everybody has a face. I take it you don't like him either.
Would you like a man who has usurped your throne, took your father off the infidels, sold your mother and sister to slavery, and forced I was simply falling in love.
Me too.
Not in my avenue, though. Okay, good luck. Sue the position. No sober 40 tonight. Your minutes at midnight? You can do it, Spencer.
And no supper. I did it.
What a weak man you are.
I'll be back after dark. I'll bring food.
And that voice, please.
Not of love, but of political
What challenge? Tell me now, please.
The challenge of the Druid Prom Queen. The challenger asks the king for a dance. The king then says no. And the challenger throws a black moustache in his face and steps on the king's toe.
And then
Then there is music and mayhem. And the winner gets me.
And what does
Firefriend figured that he was going to go out there half-cocked. He might look nice.
He gave him the horse to ride the fastest, most beautiful steed in all the kingdom.
Ah, yes, Pepper. Truly a horse fit for a king. It has been said that she can look faster than the wind, if the wind was blowing really, really slow.
So, Ivanhoe left the comfort and security of this of the abbey to fight forces with the pseudo king.
And find fair ladies' hearts.
It was a magnificent sight.
Yes, it was.
Something
be known to all of the realm that your king, Viscera Bayons Infra, Duke of Worcestershire and King of all Saxons, will soon be wed to this lovely gem. Ow! This fragile figurine. Ow! This fragrant flower. Lady Lenore of the House of Mushrooms.
Thank you. I owe it to all those squirrels who made me just what I am today. Viscera, I believe this dance is mine. Squeak!
Thank you.
Thank you all so much. You've been such a lovely audience the past four nights. So it takes a lot to come up here and put this together for you guys. It takes countless hours, countless team bonding, and team ripping each other apart for taking those heads off. But besides that, like, we do this just for you guys, just to put on the show, just to be a treat to you guys. And we really appreciate all your support, and we hope to see you during the spring play slash musical, whatever it is. But I'd love to see you guys again, and we all would. Thank you guys so much.